Hello my dear students, today in this video you will going to learn notes and exercise of chapter 9 soil. This chapter is considered in biology because it is related with the ecosystem. So let's start with the first note. Here comes it is, that is soil. Okay, so definition is there, the mixture of rock particles and humus is called the soil. Okay, so as you know that soil is made up from the bedrocks. Okay, it breaks down by the weathering process and converted into the powdered form called soil. Along with that, some dead and decaying matter which converted into humus. Okay, so this mixture of rock particles and humus is called soil. Moving to the next, that is soil profile. Soil profile means, as you see, if you visit any construction site, so over there you can see that it is having different layers, the dark color, then the lighter one, then the huge rock particles. Okay, so this is the layers of the soil. The vertical section of the soil is considered as a soil profile. Okay, moving to the next is humus. Humus means whatever the living beings will going be dead. Okay, so the some dead and decaying matter, or should I say the rotting dead matter, is considered as a humus. Moving to the next, that is weathering. Weathering is the process of breakdown of bed rocks and convert it into soil. This process is known as weathering process. Okay, and it is done by some agents, weathering agents like wind, water, changing in temperature, natural calamity, etc. Okay, now next one is loamy soil. Okay, but before that, let me start with the sandy soil, so it would be much easier to understand. Sandy soil means the soil which contains big particles. You know, you have seen sand, so it is having very big particle compared to the clay and loam. Okay, so the bigger particle of the soil, such kind of soil is considered as a sandy soil. If you don't understand the actual particle size of sandy soil, then let me give you one example. You have seen suji or rava. आपने रवा और सूजी देखा होगा, उसका जो बड़ी सूजी आती है उसके particle size कैसा होता है, almost same to same sandy soil का भी होता है. Moving to the next, that is clayey soil. The very fine particle soil is considered as a clayey soil. Suppose for example, जैसे आपका घर का आटा हो गया, ओके, सो जैसा उसका स्ट्रक्चर टेक्सचर होता है, सेम टू सेम क्ले सॉइल का भी वैसा ही टेक्सचर होता है. नेक्स्ट वन इज लोमी सॉइल. लोमी सॉइल इज हैविंग बोथ पार्टिकल साइज, बिगर वन ऑल्सो एंड स्मॉलर और फाइन पार्टिकल्स इन अ सेम क्वान्टिटी इज कंसिडर एज अ लोमी सॉइल. यू हैव सीन बॉर्नविटा, आपने बॉर्नविटा देखा होगा, उसके अंदर पाउडर्ड फॉर्म भी होता है और थोड़ा बहुत ग्रैन्यूअल फॉर्म भी होता है. सो लोमी सॉइल का भी ऐसा ही बेसिकली स्ट्रक्चर होता है. सो हियर आर द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सॉइल. नेक्स्ट वन इज परकोलेशन. परकोलेशन मीन्स द सॉइल पार्टिकल्स इज हैविंग माइनर गैप बिटवीन द पार्टिकल्स. ओके, एंड फ्रॉम थ्रू दैट गैप्स द वॉटर कैन बी इजिली मूव डाउनवर्ड. सो दिस डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू द सॉइल पार्टिकल्स इज नोन एज परकोलेशन. ओके, एंड time taken for this downward movement in the soil is known as percolation rate. You can write this percolation rate in terms of equation also, that amount of water in millimeter which is going to be percolated, okay, and time taken for this percolation is known as percolation rate. Next one is our exercise. So all the notes are finished. We're now moving to the next for the exercise. For the exercise, two questions are there, which is MCQ. So first let's understand. In addition to the rock particles, the soil contains option A, air and water, option B, water and plants, option C, minerals, organic matter, air and water, and option 4 is water, air and plants. You can see in the first, second and fourth, one element is one or two element is less, which is minerals and organic matter. Okay, so answer should be the third one, because in that everything is there. Moving to the next, the water holding capacity is highest in option A sandy soil, option B clay soil, option C loamy soil, and option 4 mixture of sand and loam. You know that clay soil consists of very fine particles. Okay, so due to that reason, very minor space is there between the particles, and hence it can easily able to hold the water. So answer is clay soil. Moving to the next is subjective question, that is explain how soil is formed. We just now discussed about it in the weathering process, that the huge parent rock, or should I say bedrock, break down by the weathering process, and the agents are wind, water, and some natural calamity or climate. Due to that reason, these whole bedrocks break down into the smaller and smaller, and finally converted into the powdered form. This process, or should I say the soil formation process, is known as weathering process. So here our question finished. Moving to the next, that how is clay soil useful for crops? So you know, some crops require more amount of water. Okay, for example, rice need maximum water. Okay, so such kind of crops, for that clay soil is best. The reason is that this gap between the particles is very less. Due to that reason, it can hold the water for a long time. Okay, so thus the crops which require more water, they will grow well in the clay soil. Next one is match the following your favorite part. Here comes the first, a home of living organism. So you know that any kind of soil is suitable for the living beings to stay. So answer is the B option, all kind of soil. Next one is upper layer of the soil, or should I say A horizon. So the characteristic of A horizon is it is dark in color. Okay, it contains maximum amount of humus. Okay, porous in nature. So you know that out of these properties, the dark in color option is given. So answer is C. Third one is sandy soil. Sandy soil is having large particles. This is the first characteristic. So answer is A. Next one is middle layer of the soil. So middle layer of the soil characteristic, you know that it is less dark in color because it contains less humus. It contains lots of water and minerals in it. Okay. Out of this characteristic, into this column, it is written that lesser amount of humus. So this option is given. So answer is E, lesser amount of humus. Last one is clay soil. So clay soil's characteristic, very small particles, less space, means they are completely packed with each other, the particles. Okay, so answer is small particles and packed tight. Okay, here our match the following complete. Moving to the next is difference between clay soil and sandy soil. So first we will going to write about sandy soil, and then we'll move for the clay soil. So here comes the first point, is about its particle size. So first point is that sandy soil is having very bigger particles. On the other hand, clay soil is having very fine particles. Second one is that sandy soil is having very large amount of gaps between the particles, and due to that reason, water can easily move downwards. Hence, it consists of high percolation rate. On the other hand, clay soil has fine particles, and hence it can easily hold the water, and water cannot move easily through downward. Okay, so hence it is low percolation rate. Next is water holding capacity. So as I spoke that the bigger the gap between the particles, the less amount of water can be held. And due to that reason, sandy soil is having low water holding capacity, while clay soil is having high water holding capacity. So this percolation and water holding is directly depend on the size of particles and gaps between the particles. Next one is sketch the cross section of soil and label the various layers. Okay, so it is already given inside the textbook, the soil profile. You can see, mention carefully all the labels. You have to mention at one side only. That is your choice, to mention it right side or left side. Okay, so first one is A horizon, second B horizon, third C horizon, and last one is parent rock, or should I say bedrock. So like this way you have to draw it and label it properly. Okay, in the exam this question can be asked in 2 marks. The one is completely proper drawing, half mark is there. Okay, and for the labeling also 1 mark is there. Okay, so proper labeling along with proper drawing, you will going to get 2 marks. Next one is the sum. Razia conducted an experiment in the field related to the rate of percolation. Okay, means she want to observe regarding rate of percolation. So she observed that it took 40 minutes. 40 minutes is stand for the time quantity. So time is given 40 minutes for 200 milliliter of water to percolate through the soil sample. Means 200 ml. Okay, so which is showing you that how much water is percolating or how much water she took. Okay, so we got amount of water also and time taken for the percolation also. What we have to do, we have to directly put this information into the equation. Equation is likewise rate of percolation equal to amount of water which is going to be percolated upon, means in the denominator, percolation time. Okay, so let's keep this data 200 millimeter in numerator and 40 minutes in denominator. So you can see that 0 0 cuts and over here 4 is given and 4 5s are 20. So final answer is 5 milliliter per minute. It means that within 1 minute total 5 ml water will be going to percolate through the soil. Okay, so like this way any question can be asked to you, you must have to just remember the equation. Okay, next one is explain how soil pollution and soil erosion could be prevented. So the very basic thing is that to save our ecosystem is that nothing but the trees. Okay, if you stop cutting the trees, if you stop the deforestation, definitely your ecosystem will going to be safe. So over here also same thing is applicable. Cutting of the trees and deforestation should be prevented and effort should be made to increase the green areas, because you know that trees can hold the soil very firmly, so it will going to stop the soil erosion, and also trees are going to consume the maximum amount of pollutants inside it and convert it into the simpler one. Okay, so hence it will going to stop the soil pollution as well as the soil erosion. Okay, so and also inside the textbook one cross down and crossword is also given, which is completely fun to you. So I hope that you will going to solve it on your own. One more reminder that on this note our exercise finishes. Next time we will going to come with the new chapter which is about physics. But before that, let me remind you that beta, please start writing the chapters inside the notes. Okay, we are going to provide you the PDF also. Okay, so go through it and start writing. I hope you enjoy the video. Stay happy, have a nice day.